So last day we have discussed about this LR0 parser, and we have seen that how this LR0 for parsing using LR0 parser, how we can proceed. We will design the state diagram first with this augmented production rule, having this new production, that is what we call augmented production. And then using this particular state diagram, we will design the LR0 parsing table. And in this LR0 parsing table, what we have seen, that each and every cell will be either blank or will have either some shift move, or will have either some reduce move, something like this. And we note what particular reduce move we have over here based on the numbering of the productions written in the I mean considered in the grammar, right? And only in this row number one, since this row number one is representing the state number I1, which contains only the augmented production, we consider x rate for the dollar and nothing else in other cells. So now you see, last day we, when we stopped our discussion, I raised a term about conflict, right? What is conflict? The idea of conflict you have already got in LL1 parsing table. We have seen that we can have two production in the same cell in the table. That's basically the conflict, right? So the idea is same over here also. Now what we have to do, we have to understand in which situation we can have a conflict in this LR0 parsing table. And remember, if you have a conflict in at least one cell, I mean even in one cell in a LR0 parsing table, that means surely I can say that LR0 parser cannot be drawn for that particular production rule or for that particular grammar. Because even for a single cell in the whole parsing table, if you have the conflict, there will be a chance that LR0 parsing algorithm will be confused at that point when that particular cell has to use. Anyway, so before we before we go through a detail of this, so let's start with this topic first. So we will start with the topic for today, that is conflict in LR0 parsing table. So you see, to realize this, I will take a very simple example. Just assume that we have a state over here, like you have a state I. Suppose some state I is here present. Okay. And from this state, because of some production, say, suppose we have, okay, let's draw a production rule here, then it will be much more clear. So suppose, let's take a big circle here, and suppose we have a production rule here, for example, that is A2 dot A. Okay, and say B2 some alpha dot. I'm not interested what exactly alpha is, but one thing is sure here, that this B2 alpha dot is a final item, right? That we have seen in the previous class, that if you have dot at the end, that means everything is seen and there is nothing to do on in this production. So this is the final item, right? So now for this particular, from this particular state I, what I can do, I can have a transition because of this small a present in this production, right? So I can write, like, for a small a, I can may jump to a new state over here, right? And that basically will be, say, suppose that ij, that is a new state, and the production rule that I will have over here is basically a to a dot. Fine. Now just try to understand what will happen in case of designing the parsing table. You know, in the parsing table, you know, suppose we have lot of states over here. So I'm not interested for the other states in the state diagram. I'm interested for only the ith state. So assume that you have a set of terminal present over here, not only A, maybe other terminals are present in other part of the state diagram, which is not shown here. So maybe that is A, or it can be B, or it can be C. Even after C, I will have dollar, and there will be something on the, you know, go to part, something like that, right? For example, capital A, capital B, at least I can say, right? Because these two non-terminals are present here, so at least in these two these two will be in the go-to part. Now assume this ith row. This is the ith row, which is representing this ii state, right? Now according to the previous case, previous day, what we have seen, for example, you see, if you are in this i0 state and if you jump to this i3 state because of this small a, because you are exploiting this production rule a to small a capital A, what actually we write corresponding to the table, in the zeroth row, you see, in the zeroth row we have written, for since for small a you are jumping to i3, we write under zero row and a column s3, that means shift to 3, right? So that means in the same way, what I can do over here, I can write that for ith row, for small a, I'm jumping to jth state. That means I can write here sj, shift to j, right? Fine, this is okay. Now problem will arise for this final item, because in case of final item, again, if you go back, what we have seen, that for example over here, this a to b dot is a final item, and because of this, what we have done in the fourth row, in the fourth row we have, in the entire column of the fourth row, at least in the action part, we have considered the reduced move. Which reduced move? The reduced move that contain a to b, that is r3. That's why I have written r3 here. So this is the nature of LR0 parsing table, that when we write reduce move, we don't check a particular column, rather in all the columns of that row we put the reduce move. Now what will happen? Assume that this b to alpha dot, this particular reduce move b to alpha dot, not dot, you know, if you don't need to write dot here. So for assume that this particular production rule is, say, RK production rule, RK, maybe R1, R2, R3, some RK, okay. And because of the nature, what we can write, since this II contain this reduce move, that means in the ith row, for each and every column, I will put this particular RK, right? So that means I will have, you can say that I will have RK here, I can have RK here, I can have RK here, even I can have RK here also, right? And you see, this is the part where I have the conflict, right? That in a particular cell, I have shift move as well as the reduce move. And this type of conflict is specially what we call shift reduce conflict. Because one move is for shift and one move is for reduce. Whatever it may be, since it is a conflict, so definitely the LR0 parser cannot be created, cannot be designed for the particular grammar present over here. Now, there is one more situation we can have. What is that? Let's take a different case. Like, again, the same thing we are considering, that I have a state over here. Okay. And that state contain two production rule. Suppose one is A to alpha dot and B to beta dot. Now, I'm not interested what exactly alpha and beta is. My point is that if this is again the ith state, what do we know? If we have a reduced move over here, I have to put in the entire row and assume that this A to alpha, this production rule, say some RPH production rule, and B to beta, this production rule is some RQH production rule. Whatever RP value of P and Q is, P may be 1, Q may be 2, or maybe something like that, any different, any positive number. That is not important. Important is that this is PH production rule and this is QH production rule, and R I have written because this is for reduced move. Now try to realize the situation from the LR0 parsing table point of view. What will happen over here? If we do the same thing, I mean, I have say several non-terminals here, ABC or maybe dollar or something like that. Obviously A and B will be there as two columns in the go to part, and this is for the action part, and again we are considering the ith row because representing this I state. What we will find out, we will see that because of this particular reduce move A to alpha, I will put, and since this particular, I mean, consider as a final item in the ith state, so in the ith row I will have RP in all the columns. I will not see where exactly RP will be used. But problem is that in the same production, I mean in the same state, we have another reduced move, right? That is B to beta, that what we consider RQ. And because of this one, obviously this production will also claim the same location in each and every cell of that particular row. Right, and this is again going to get a conflict. But specifically, what you can say, this is reduce conflict. This is, you know, in other words, you can say this is SR conflict and this is RR conflict. So basically, we will find these two different type of conflict in any parser. Not only in LR0 parser, in other parsers also. So what we have to do? If I ask you that, tell me if you have this grammar and can I design LR0 parser or not? Actually, your motivation will to realize whether I will have any SR or RR conflict in the parsing table or not. If you find there is no SR or RR conflict, then it's okay. You can easily design a LR0 parsing table. And if you are capable to design LR0 parsing table, you can easily use that parsing table for LR0 parsing algorithm. So this type of question, you know, very frequently come in various exams, including GATE and other competitive exams. So you must have some practice, you know, those who are seriously interested for, you know, giving GATE or any other competitive exams in future, they at least you know, take this part seriously in the compiler design portion, very seriously, that they should have a practice to find out whether we can have any SR or RR conflict in some parsing table or not. Okay. So this is all about the LR0 parsing table actually. You know, we will realize you know, in future, if you do some practice on different production rule, then we will have some practice and we will see that whether some LR, our production rule is LR0 parsable or not.